Hello everyone, welcome to my YouTube channel. I hope you all are doing well. I am going to explain fundamental theorem of arithmetic and its applications. This is class 10th topic. Let us understand the definition or the statement of fundamental theorem of arithmetic. We have already learnt about prime and composite numbers in our previous classes. As we already know that except one, all the numbers are either prime or composite. What are composite numbers? Those numbers which can be written as product of its factors. So this is all about the composite numbers, that if we have a positive integer which is composite, then we can factorize it in the form of product of primes, and this factorization will be unique. What this means is that suppose we take example of 140, then we are getting the prime factorization as 2 square into 5 into 7. Then this factorization will be unique every time. That is, every time we are going to get the prime factors only 2, 5 and 7, and no other factor will be there in the factorization. And the order will not matter here. That is, we can shift 2, 5 and 7. Either we can write 5 first, 7 last, or whatever order can change, but the factors will remain same. Next application of the fundamental theorem is, we have to check whether 6 raised to the power n can end with digit 0 for any natural number n. For this, we should understand first that in order to end with digit 0, a number should have prime factorization like 2 into 5. Because only these two factors are going to make the number 0, that is number 10 at the end. So if we see the prime factorization of 6 raised to the power n, we are not getting the number 5 in the factorization, which is missing here. So 6 raised to the power n will never end with digit 0. Next application is to find out the HCF and LCM. In order to find out the HCF and LCM, what we have to do is, we are having two steps. Firstly, what is HCF? It is highest common factor. And what is LCM? It is least common multiple. Now, for highest common factor and least common multiple, every time we have to look for the common factors. And when these common factors are searched, we will look for the powers of them. If we have the case of HCF, we will take the smallest powers. And if we have the case of LCM, we have to search for the greatest powers. Let us understand with the help of example. Suppose we want to find out the LCM of 48 and 72 using the fundamental of theorem of arithmetic. Then 48 can be written as 2 raised to the power 4 into 3 raised to the power 1, and 72 can be written as 2 cube into 3 square. Now here the smallest powers of 2 and 3 are 3. You have to compare this power of 2. This is 4 here and this is 3 in the next number. So in case of HCF, you will take the minimum one, and in case of LCM, you have to take the maximum. So LCM will become 2 raised to the power 4 and HCF will become 2 raised to the power 3. Similarly, for the factor 3, you will write down the powers. In case of LCM, you will write 2 power, and in case of HCF, you will write power 1. So basically, you have to compare the powers. Whatever is minimum will go in HCF, and whatever is maximum will go in LCM. Next, we have another example for HCF and LCM. Suppose we have two numbers which are having factorization 2 cube into 3 square into 5 raised to the power 6 into 7 and 2 into 5 raised to the power 9 into 13 square. Then in order to find out the HCF, again we have to look for the first common factors and their minimum powers. So when we are writing the common factors, 13 was missing in the first number. So I have written 13 raised to the power 0, which we can write because anything raised to the power 0 is 1. Similarly, for number 2, we were having 3 and 7 missing. So I have written 3 raised to the power 0 and 7 raised to the power 0 in the prime factorization of the second number. Now look for the minimum powers. So for 2, it is already 1 power minimum. For 3, it is power 0. And for 5, it is power 6. For 7, it is power 0. Again, for 13, it is power 0. So our HCF is done. Similarly, we can find LCM. Next application is the result, which is LCM into HCF is equals to product of two numbers. Be very cautious. This is true only in case of two numbers. When we are having the three numbers, this result will not hold. That is, LCM into HCF will not be equal to the product of three numbers, which I have written here. Let us verify this for 26 and 91. When we are finding LCM and HCF, these are coming 182 and 13. And when we are taking the product of LCM and HCF, it is 2366. Similarly, the product of 26 and 91, it is again 2366, which verifies the result. Next application is the decimal expansions and how to check whether the rational numbers terminate or they are having non-terminating repeating decimal expansion. For that, what we have to do is, suppose we are having one rational number, then in order to check whether the decimal expansion is terminating or not, we will write the prime factorization of the denominator. And suppose it is here 3 by 8, so it becomes 3 upon 2 raised to the power 3. But as we already know, in order to convert into a decimal, we need zeros in the denominator. So for those zeros, what we have to do, we have to include 5 here. Now, which power of 5 we have to include, we will get that idea with the help of power of 2 here. It is the power of 2 is 3 here. So that means you have to include a number 5 with power of 3 only, so that you can make 10 cube in the denominator, and you will get the result as the value of decimal expansion as 0.375. One more result is, suppose it is not of the form 2 raised to the power n and 5 raised to the power m, then what you will do? That means here we can see in the example 11 by 30, it is having 2, 3 and 5. That means this 3 is extra. So in those cases, the decimal expansion will be non-terminating and repeating. Without calculating, you can directly write down that. I hope you liked the video. Thank you so much for watching the video.